Team ranked 19th in the nation. He seeded 9th in its conference tournament. But that's the case with UConn. A 9-9 league record taking on DePaul in game one.
DePaul. UConn has yet to look sharp in their half-court execution, friend.
Yep, and I've coached against Oliver Purnell. He loves to change defenses, and particularly out of TV timeouts.
Jeremy Lamb from downtown. He was a Big East all-rookie team member. 4-7 for Moses Morgan off the bench to lead DePaul.
I like when Napier has the ball in the half court. I really think their offense flows better.
UConn on a 5-0 run, and again, Walker giving it up. Lamb baseline, leaning in, and a blocking foul.
Now this guy has been able to carry the load. He upped his numbers actually in conference just slightly, and this is why you think they've got a chance to be good.
Walker has one assist, and here he is again in transition, giving it up to Napier, and Lamb with a great one-handed finish on the alley-oop, and a foul.
Pretty, pretty pass. Napier has made two terrific finds, and again, he gets the ball in his hands. They look like a different team. It allows Kemba to get off the basketball. Watch this, a little look away, and how about the catch and athleticism by Mr. Lamb?
That was a no-look alley here, too. Came to the All-Big East rookie team, led all rookies in assists. Young did as Lamb takes off, soaring in for the dunk. 24 for UConn.
Good look.
Lamb down court will take it in, and now has 17 points. Timeout DePaul. Scores. Brandon Young has 18 to top DePaul. And Drew's three blocked by Lamb. Walker with a great look ahead. And Lamb with the basket. He's got 19. Connecticut has won 6 Big East championships, the last coming in 2004. Georgetown won its 7th crown in 2007 and has made it to the finals 3 of the last 4 years.
That means the bigs have got to be active with their feet.
Here's Lamb for 3, and this guy has a bright future in basketball. 6'5", freshman, very long. He can shoot it. He's got 4 points. Here's Lamb, and another reason why Jeremy Lamb is a guy to watch in years to come. And again, Villanova's got some huge wins this year. A steal by Lamb. He'll take it himself.
Kid's going to be a player.
Here comes UConn. Napier got the defender in the air. Beverly with the extra pass. Lamb got the rebound, sticks it back in. The lead is 15.
They're just quicker to the basket.
UConn has been on the court at Madison Square Garden twice this week. Pitt takes the hardwood for the first time. And the Panthers are 0-2 at the Big East tournament when they've had the double bye. Here's the talented freshman Jeremy Lamb, all Big East rookie team, only going to get better as time goes on.
Outstanding decision, and Kemba Walker sprints to...
and has done a wonderful job. But by the way, guys like Tom Izzo and Jim Boeheim are good role models.
Lamb up high and slams it down on the alley-oop.
Always like to see what coaches do out of a timeout.
Not necessarily anything for next season, although the Big East would not comment on any further punishment for next year. As Lamb drives the lane, and he's starting to get it going for UConn. That forces Jamie Dixon to call a timeout.
Doris, Pittsburgh is consistent. Everything they do, every practice, every drill, building habits defensively, offensively, consistency of effort.
Lamb inside, counted, and a foul on Pittsburgh. Winning the Big East tournament. They lost last night in their first game. A steal by Lamb, and Lamb soaring for the jam, making a 4-point game again.
Tonight, Connecticut, the number 19 team in the country, the number 9 seed in the Big East Championship, takes on Syracuse, number 11 in the nation, and the 4 seed here at the Big East Championship. In fact, 3 of the top 4 seeds have moved on to the semifinals. Only Pittsburgh did not, knocked out by Connecticut yesterday. So Syracuse, Notre Dame, and Louisville tonight playing for just the 2nd day in a row, while Connecticut will be playing for the 4th time in as many. Oriaki for Jim Calhoun.
Get some good movement from Lamb.
Tough, tough. That's really pretty.
How about it? We're talking about Hall of Fame coaches. Calhoun.
Huge possession. Everyone big now. Lamb for 3.
Woo! Wow.
McDaniel or Lamb in the middle.
Boy, Jardine deflected that pass. Lamb, a one-handed floater for Connecticut.
Bring a ball screen to him.
Olander, now Lamb, nice move to get free. Floater good. Jeremy Lamb.
Then goes to his right on the catch against the closeout. Splits.
And how about the runner? Isn't that amazing?
That is big time.
That is tough to convert as well. Twice. Bringing that bell. Big time.
Tonight it's Connecticut, the number 19 team in the country, the number 9 seed in this Big East championship against Louisville, the number 14 team in the country, and the 3 seed. In the
big matchup, Lamb on Knowles.
And Siva.
Walker on Siva, quick on quick.
Walker passes it off to Jeremy Lamb, and the Huskies have the first bucket of the night. Charles Okwandu's checked in, number 35 for UConn. Tough shot, and the banker good for Jeremy Lamb, the rebounder in this Big East championship.
A lot of offensive rebounds available for Louisville.
Louisville's 1 out of 9 so far from three. Lamb a three.
Wow.
Another timeout called by Rick Pitino. They're playing with 2 fouls. Jennings has 2. Siva 2. For Louisville. Elisha Justice pestered by Napier, who poked it away. Shabazz Napier. And the dunk by Lamb after Keurig defended the original shot. Timeout Louisville. McDaniel plays it in to Napier. Walker, Oriaki, and Lamb. About 15 seconds difference between the game and shot clocks.
Going with a horn set.
Walker into the traffic. Dumps it off for Lamb. UConn by 1. 33 to go.
Spots by Walker. He looks like he's in trouble here. Keeps it low and then finds.
We just went with something called a horn set. One man pops, the other rolls, and Kemba just made the play by himself, drew the defense.
Brings you to Washington, D.C., the West Region second round, Bucknell against the mighty Huskies, tournament champions.
Lamb, he's going to be a big time scorer, Timmy, as his career goes along. And
well, Roscoe Smith had lost a shoe and got it back on.
Lamb off the feed from Walker.
Johnson is with the Cleveland Cavaliers.
Walker with the clock at 6 is rejected. Nice work by Boone. But Lamb answers from downtown.
And it's pulled down by Oriaki.
Very few second chance opportunities for Bucknell. That shooting percentage is going to have to come up.
Lamb. Oh. Raining threes.
You get a good look, you're saying to yourself, I gotta make this shot.
Yeah.
Lamb again, the 3 ball for Jeremy Lamb.
Well, I tell you, he is just fantastic. And years ago, people remember how explosive Damari Carroll was, and they really have not been able to supplement the energy on the defensive end of this point as Lamb hits off the bounce again. But you can rest assured tonight,
as our coverage of the men's NCAA basketball championship brings you back to Washington, D.C. for the West Region. And for the first time since the tournament expanded in 85, two neighbors from the same league meet, the earliest ever since we expanded beyond 64.
Shot clock at 10, and Lamb cans it. That's a 2 just inside the arc. Dixon gets the loose ball.
There's a steal by Lamb. There's that wingspan coming into play that you were talking about.
Close, look at the top of your screen as you see Kashmir Wright taking it in. K-State and Wisconsin have a great one finishing up.
All right, that's the play. And I just, you know, Kashmir Wright, I don't know that he's got any lift in that left leg, Tim. Or just Deion Dixon just locked into Kemba Walker right now. Walker only 2 points so far in this half.
Lamb.
Great screen by Oriaki.
Yep, rattling at home. The freshman has 11. 40. Lamb again on the wing.
See, that's a great play by Kemba Walker. Through dribble penetration, he draws the zone in, and he got the freshman a nice jump shot.
This game is brought to you in HDTV by LG. Life's good. The officiating crew who have advanced, as teams do in the tournament. Saw their names.
They had hoped to establish Oriaki early. They're settling deep, though, and why not?
Lamb. This season, they won their last seven, five in a row in the Big East tournament to capture that, and then their first down, first two.
How about that floater?
Jeremy Lamb, my goodness.
Ooh, a little kiss.
Baseline bunch for Lamb. Five in the shot clock.
I don't know if he realizes it.
Way outside.
Ooh. Of course he did. I had it all the way, coach.
That's unconscious.
Call that number once more.
Oh, my gracious.
Does this sound familiar to you?
It does. Lamb. Oh, beautiful.
He's got great technique, this kid. Still a great play, though.
Yeah. Lamb. Ankle breaker.
He's tough. He's got Walker's move in 5 more inches.
Oriaki at the free throw line. Napier. Nice.
Wow,
beautiful.
Nice read and, of course, available.
Walker's got it. Whoa. Close. Short. On the floor. Lamb for three.
Dagger. Kicked out on an offensive rebound.
Walker crossover.
Ankle breaker.
Yes, indeed. But he missed it. Leonard, Gay. Oh, stolen by Lamb. Here's Napier. He so unselfishly gives it to Lamb.
Smart play. Nobody packing the tag. Play big, coaches say. Put your hands up. Lamb on the run. Not too bad, huh?
Unselfish.
You can rip. You can get the foul.
Leonard for three.
There you go.
Rebound, Napier. Lamb tracks it down. There's the punctuation point.
It's March Madness.
We have moved out west for this second game on the middle Saturday in March Madness. From Anaheim, California, the Arizona Wildcats out of the Pac-10 take on the UConn Huskies from the Big.
Got a good challenge on Mays.
Napier. Walker. Oh, how about that quick move?
Nice
Lamb floater beauty.
How about the control, too? Coverage there.
Jordan Mays. Now here's Walker. There's a mismatch. Not Gotsko. They leave. Lamb open. Kemba Walker will inbound.
Pretty yeah. Play. Just a stack of old Celtic play. Well, couldn't get a cleaner look.
He hit 4 from 4 in the win over Texas last weekend. Walker, skip pass, Lamb, three.
How about being in the right spot?
He's in this second half doing the same. Oh, Rocky back on. Lamb, floater.
Yes. Pretty call off the bench. They like those baseline rubs.
He was trying to slip by him. UConn with a chance to reclaim the lead. Kemba Walker, only 1 of 5 in this half.
Same play, same result.
Williams wants it down deep. Spin move, backward pass.
The long
stolen Lamb.
Amazing length. Don't buy his shirt, you can't afford it.
A pilfer to me.
Right up your alley, kid. Don't put your glasses on the table, huh? Take a look at this one. Send it in, Lamb on the run.
Well, the Kentucky Wildcats taking the floor here at a Final Four for the first time since 1998. Meanwhile, the Huskies since 1999, no, this is their fourth trip to the Final Four. They come out of the West again. Butler has advanced out of the Cinderella side of things, and now the traditional powers, if you will, are about to collide.
Similarity at this point is the name on the uniform, because these are totally different teams. Lamb didn't do much of anything in that game. Now he's become a star, and on cue, he knocks down the jumper. So they're just off to a cold start. We'll see if we can get it going.
Napier, no from the outside, but Smith keeps it for the Huskies. Napier snaps it over to Jeremy Lamb. Ryan through and gets the soft roll. Crawls over the front of the rim.
Walker
sets up Lamb. Look at that two-man game.
Out of the timeout, they lifted everybody else, Jim. A call
back to the zone.
Lamb. Jumper, yes.
He's actually lucky that Walker wasn't awarded two free throws.
Lamb. Everything he does, he just glides.
He is so smooth, but the curl was so well.
It is championship night in the vibrant city of Houston, Texas. The Butler Bulldogs and the Connecticut Huskies. And yes, the road ends here.
Back on that shot.
Napier, pass Smith, underneath, lost control, and Olander saves it. Feeds Lamb, and here comes Jeremy Lamb. Five out of the locker room for Lamb. Back able to come back out with it. That pass stolen. Lamb on his way.
And then going inside to Oriaki a couple of times as well.
Lamb gets it right back. Left open, baseliner, and Jeremy Lamb.
He has really stepped on the gas pedal, hasn't he?
Heaped it up.
Half.
Yes, indeed. Lamb with nine.
And this is where UConn can really exploit its advantage with Lamb trying to beat the pitcher. That's the goal.
Napier to Lamb for two more.